What's up, YouTube family? It's your boy, King Abe. Welcome back to my channel. So guys, in this video today, I'm gonna be showing you guys a highly profitable scalping strategy that you guys can use, even if you're a beginner, to make 20 pips a day. So if this is your first time on my channel, all I ask is that if you find value in this video, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and turn on the bell notification so you guys don't miss any of my future videos. So now, without further ado, let's roll out the intro, and I will see you guys inside. For this scalping strategy, we're actually going to be using three indicators for this scalping strategy, and I actually recommend you guys to use this strategy on the 5-minute time frame, simply because it works better on the 5-minute time frame. Now, to use this scalping strategy, what I want you guys to do is that you need to know that for this strategy, your goal, your target profit has to be 20 pips a day. That's your target profit for this strategy every single day. So you need to make sure your goal is to make 20 pips a day. That's what this scalping strategy is for. So now, the first thing I want you guys to do when you want to use this strategy is to go here to indicators, and the first indicator we're going to add is going to be moving average. Make sure it's moving average exponential. So EMA, make sure it's moving average exponential. As you guys can see, you type moving average exponential, and you should see it right here. It's gonna pop up, and make sure you guys have a make sure you guys make it one of your favorites. So you just click on it twice, and then once you're done with that, then you go here to settings. Right here in settings, the first one I want you guys to change that to 25, and for the style, you know, just use whatever color you want. I'm gonna leave this color right here, and then you click on OK. Now, for this one right here, the second one, I want you guys to change this to 200. You change that to 200, and you can just change the color. I'll use this right here, and then once you're done, you click on OK. Now, that's that for the EMA. So make sure you add the moving average exponential EMA. Now, the final indicator we're gonna add this time around, we're gonna add Ichimoku cloud. We're gonna add the Ichimoku cloud. So right here, you search for Ichimoku, and it's gonna pop up, and then make sure you guys make this one of your favorite as well if you want to use this strategy, so it'll be easier for you to add it onto your charts. So now, when we click on Ichimoku cloud, now you go here to settings. All the things you need to change, you just need to focus on changing the conversion line. We take that off, baseline, and the lagging span. And then once you're done, you click on OK. You leave everything else as it is. Now, when you want to use this strategy, now if we take a look at this sell trade right here, this sell right over here, as you guys can see. Now, I'll be showing you guys two examples. I'll be showing you guys a sell example and a buy example for this strategy. Now, when we look at this sell right here, now there are some rules that you need to follow. So there are some confirmations you guys need to be looking out for, and you need to be very, very patient when you're using this strategy, and you cannot be greedy when you're using this strategy. Now, when we look at this Ichimoku cloud, now what you need to be looking out for is that price has to be below this Ichimoku cloud. For a sell, price has to be below this Ichimoku cloud, and the cloud has to be red. This is the Ichimoku cloud right over here. So that's the cloud right over there. So it has to be red and price has to be below the cloud. Now, once you have that first confirmation, your second confirmation is that you need to make sure price is below the 200 EMA. We need to make sure price is below the 200 EMA and also below the 25 EMA. And we need to see this cross right here. We need to make sure the 25 crosses the 200 EMA and price has to be below the cloud. Now, once we have those confirmation, now what we now waiting for is now, because we have this cross right over here, once we have the cross, once we have all our confirmations, now we don't get in the trade immediately. We need to be patient and we need to look for more confirmation. Now, the final confirmation we need to be looking out for is, if we look over here to the left-hand side, we can see that we have a support zone. We can see that we have a support zone right over here. As you guys can see, you can see that we have a support zone right over here. Now that we have that support zone right over there, now what we're waiting for is, we have our cross, 25 crosses the 200 EMA, price is below the Ichimoku cloud. Now we just wait for more confirmation. We wait for price to close below our support zone, then we wait for a retest, and then we get in. Now I'm going to show you guys, I'll put this in replay mode, and I'll show you guys where your entry will be for this strategy. So let me put this in replay mode. Let's take a look and let's see. I'll start from right over here and let's take a look. So we have the break right over there. Now let's look and see where our entry will be. Bam. So your entry would be right over here. We'll have our entry right over here at this second bearish candle right over here. And then now we're just going to target our 20 pips. We'll have our 20 pips right there, and we have our stop loss right above our support zone, previous support zone right over here to the left hand side. Now that became a resistance right over here. Now let's see how this trade played out. Then we got our take profit smash right over there for 20 pips right there, risk to reward ratio 2-to-1. So guys, this is how you use this strategy for a sell trade. Now let's look for a buy example. So I'm going to show you guys a buy example now. Let's look for a buy example. Let's see. All right, now looking at this buy right over here, you need some confirmations as well. We need to make sure that price is above the 200 EMA and the 25 EMA, and we need to make sure that price is also above the cloud, because when you guys look at this, you need to make sure that the cloud is green. You need to make sure that this cloud right here you guys are looking at, you need to make sure it's green and price is above the cloud. Now, once we have those confirmations, now what we need to be waiting for now is that we need to make sure that once we have this 225 crossing the 200 EMA, now we need to wait for our entry. So now what else do we see? We can see right over here to the left hand side that we actually have a resistance zone here that we need to be, you know, looking out for. We can see that we have a resistance zone right here that was initially a support zone right over here to the left hand side, right over here that was initially a support zone and it became a resistance zone right over here. So now that we have that right over there, now what are we waiting for? Now I'm going to put this in replay mode and I will show you guys where your entry will be for this strategy. Now we're going to put this in replay mode and let's take a look and see where our entry is going to be. Start from right here when we had the cross and let's take a look. So now we have a break above this resistance zone right here. Now let's take a look and see where our entry will be. Now our entry would have been, so our entry will be right over here. Our entry will be right over here. Now we just target our 20 pips, target 20 pips. And our stop loss is just gonna be right below this zone, this resistance zone right over here. We can target 10 pips for our stop loss, risk to reward 2.0. And let's see how this trade played out. We got our take profit smash right there for 20 pips, risk to reward 2.0, stop loss 10 pips. So guys, this is how you use this strategy to make 20 pips a day. So if you find value in this video, and if this is your first time on my channel, all I ask is that you like this video, smash the subscribe button, and turn on the bell notification so you guys won't miss any of my future videos. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.